Dear student, now let's understand Melde's experiment. This is an experiment used to demonstrate stationary waves in a stretched string using a large electrically oscillating tuning fork. Here we use an electrically oscillating tuning fork in two different modes, and we demonstrate the way how stationary waves are established. There are two cases we will study. First case is the one in which we call transverse mode of oscillations in tuning fork. Let's have a look on the realistic situation. Here you can see a tuning fork is horizontally taken along with an electromagnet attached with an alternating source. When the source is switched on, you can see the fork start oscillating, and the arms of the tuning fork will start in the direction normal to their length. So you can see it will induce transverse oscillation in the string. And here you can see there are four loops being formed in the string. That means the frequency of this tuning fork is four times the fundamental frequency of the string, or it is matching with the fourth harmonic of the string. That's why four loops are being produced in the string. In this situation, if we change the frequency of tuning fork, say we slightly increase the frequency, you can see if we slightly increase the frequency, the wave will start damping out and no loops are being formed. And we further increase the frequency, then at a particular level of frequency, you can see 5 loops are being formed, because now the frequency of tuning fork is matching with the 5th harmonic of this clamped string. So this is the way we can very easily understand how resonance takes place in matching of frequencies of an external source and that of a string. Here we can also mathematically analyze the situation. In this situation, just as we can see in the picture, frequency of a string oscillation is exactly equal to the frequency of tuning fork. And if the string is vibrating in P loops, we can write it as P by 2L root of T by mu. This is a situation if a string oscillates in P loops. Here, as we can see, now the string is oscillating in 5 loops. The frequency can be given by 5 by 12 root T by mu. And here the tension can be adjusted by changing the weight in the pan. If you change the weight in the pan, obviously in this situation, the frequency will change correspondingly, number of loops will also change. If frequency of fork is constant, on increasing tension, number of loops will decrease. Let's discuss the second case for Melde's experiment, which is the longitudinal mode of oscillations in tuning fork. In this situation, we term it longitudinal mode because the vibrations of arms of tuning fork are along the length of the string. Let's have a look on the situation here. You can see the tuning fork is kept in vertical position, and when the source is switched on, in this situation, the arms of tuning forks vibrate along the length of the string, due to which the string gets slackened and then again it becomes tight, and due to this also the oscillations are induced in the string. The situation is like this. Here you can see when if this is a tuning fork and the arms are going away from the mean position, the string will be slackened in this situation. And when arms are coming close, in this situation you can see the string will become tight. So these string particles will gain kinetic energy. and when again arms will move away, the string will loose and due to kinetic energy, it will move in upward direction. So, as the arm of tuning fork oscillate in a horizontal manner or along the longitudinal way of a string, the string will first get loose, then it gets tight, again gets loose. So, due to this, the string will oscillate in perpendicular direction. But here you can see, during one oscillation of the arm of tuning fork, the string will oscillate only half oscillation. So, here we can say, frequency of oscillation of a string will be equal to half of the frequency of oscillation of tuning fork. So, in this situation, you can see, here the string is vibrating in phi loop. So, here string frequency can be written as in the above case, which we can see, this is phi by 12 root of T by mu. That means in this situation, the frequency of tuning fork is double that of the frequency of a string. Now, if we increase the frequency of tuning fork, similar to the previous case, you can see, here also the string will be in damping mode as now half of the frequency of fork is not matching with any of the harmonic of the string. Now, if we further increase it, now you can see the string will start oscillating in 6 loops. That means now half of the frequency of fork is matching with the 6th harmonic of the string oscillations. So, here we can say frequency of a string or half of the frequency of fork can always be written as P by 2 L root of T by mu if a string oscillates in P loops. Based on this experiment, a law was also deduced as we term it Melde's law, which relates number of loops obtained in the string and the tension in the string. Because by changing tension, we can change the number of loops. Let's discuss that. As we have discussed in both cases, frequency of tuning fork can be kept constant. Then we can say P root T will remain constant because the length of a string and mass current length of a string remain same. This P root T in any experiment remains same, and this we call Melde's law. And here we can say if Melde's experiment is performed for 2 different tensions, in a string, say T1 and T2, for which stationary waves are obtained with the P1 and P2 loops in a string. This implies we can use P1 root T1 is equals to P2 root T2, or we can write ratio of loops in the string for the 2 tensions, we can write root of T2 by T1. This is the way how Melde's law is used. We'll have some examples, solved examples to understand Melde's law, because there are various kind of numerical applications in which Melde's law is used.